next speaker, my favorite toastmaster in the whole world. Without ado, with this speech, well written, well prepared, Finding the Light, please join me in welcoming myself, Tim Lewis, with Finding the Light. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters, I am obsessed with photography. I love taking pictures. It's one of the greatest things you can do. You take a camera of any kind, cell phone, a fancy DSLR, something with film in it maybe, and just point it at a subject, and you have preserved that moment in amber forever. Or until you delete it accidentally because you didn't realize it was in that folder. Photography is great, but so many photographs that I get very excited to take are just terrible. I pull out my camera, I point it at someone, push the button, take a look at the back of it, and it's too dark. The camera, not a very smart device by any means, looks at the background, says this is what's important. The background is what's important. And just completely underexposes or overexposes, and my subject is just washed out or just a weird silhouette shadow, really creepy. It's a real problem. So I've come to the conclusion that taking excellent photographs is about finding the light. Now, light is everything in pictures. In case you didn't know, cameras have little photoreceptors, or old film cameras have film grain on a negative. And as light comes in through the lens, it's projected onto a tiny receiver, we'll say. And as those sensors get hit by photons, they send information to the hard drive. All you're doing is collecting light. If there's no light, you're not going to get a good picture. If there's too much light, you're not going to get a good picture. So how do you deal with this? Well, there's a variety of ways. One, you can create your light. You can go buy big expensive soft boxes and massive light modifiers that you then drag around with you everywhere. It's a lot of fun. I've tried it. It's great. I'm fun at parties. I'm just showing up like a soft box and an umbrella. It's great. You can start to modify light. This is where you look around and you say, like, okay, in this room with these lights, it's going to be pretty good from the top, but these lights on the wall are totally going to confuse the camera, which is why when I first got here, I immediately turned them off because I knew the camera was just going to be blown out and I will be a weird, creepy silhouette shadow as I speak. Or three, you can look for it. You can look for light. Now, everybody probably knows about golden hour. Golden hour is sunset, when the sun is just barely hitting the horizon. Or sunrise. I'm never up for sunrise, so I don't usually see it, other than being here at this very early time. Yeah, this is actually a great example. So, the idea is that as the sun gets down low, the light's coming through more atmosphere. And it's actually bouncing around the sky more often. So instead of getting a really hard, punchy light like you get at noon, have you ever seen those pictures of something so big? 12 o'clock during your lunch break, it's just shadows and just every little detail and every pore is just carved out. It's really hard and like not usually very attractive. But at sunset or sunrise, the light's coming from everywhere. And it's filling in any blemishes you might have. It's filling in your deep eye sockets or the light underneath your chin. You know, it's really pleasant and warm. So that's one way to deal with it. Wait until sunset or sunrise. It's not always the appropriate solution. You can't really tell people, like, look, you look great, and I'm going to take a picture of you. Let's come back in 6 hours when the sun gets really low. And that's when we'll take a picture. One thing that often works really well here in Oregon is wait for an overcast day. When there's a little bit of clouds in the sky, doesn't look like that's going to happen today, the light's already bouncing around. And it's almost like a giant softbox over the whole area. And that can be really pleasant as well. It can also be a little flat. You know, it's not a lot of dimension. Now, my favorite thing that you can do, and you can do it almost any time, is to look for what's called open shade. Open shade is where you stand right on the edge of a shadow. So, for example, let's say you're outside and you're under a carport, one of those, shields like this, so the sun isn't coming straight down. If you stand just on the edge of the shadow, you're getting all that light that's bouncing off the ground in front of you, all the light that's bouncing off whatever happens to be in your environment, all the light that's coming from the sky, but none of the hard light, none of that 12 o'clock high noon light where everything is extra crispy and fried. You get all the niceness of the light bouncing around and filling in, and none of the really harsh edges. So open shape. I feel like the key to a really great photograph is to have a good balance between light and dark. You should have enough light that you can see what your subject is, that you can highlight the features of them that you want to bring forward. And you should have enough dark that the things you're not interested in kind of fall away. Open shade, in my mind, is the best way to do this. Because if you're in shade, what's behind you is going to have less light on it, because it's completely shaded, usually. What's in front of you, which is your subject, is going to be nicely illuminated with all that light bouncing around and coming back up and filling in everything. You get that push-pull, the dark and the light. It can be so crisp and so nice. So the next time you're out and about, and you feel like taking a picture of yourself or someone else, think about open shade. Think about sitting in your car while the sun is shining outside, but you're in the shade of the car. That's why you see so many pictures of people like in their car. They look great, sitting in their car. Think about an open door or an open window. Right now, there's two windows here. I'm basing them, lights coming in. If we turned off these lights, it would look great in here. This would be an ideal location for shooting a photograph because we have west-facing window. And so none of the sunlight is coming directly in. It's all just hitting and bouncing back out. It's a great example.